Here we have 6.4, the square root addition or subtraction, simplifying. And here the radicands, right, what's inside the radicals do not match. So we cannot add them and subtract them the way they are right now. However, we can simplify them and then hopefully the radicands will match and we'll be able to actually add and subtract. These are like the same thing as saying these are not like terms and therefore cannot be combined until they look like they're like terms. So I'm gonna take 32 off to the side. I know that that is 4 times 8. 4 is 2 times 2. 8 is 2 times 4, and 4 is 2 times 2. Now remember, you want to have, this is a 2, so you want to have pairs and then your leftovers. So I have a pair of 2's here. So I'm going to have square root of 2 squared. I have a pair of 2's here. So another square root of 2 squared. And then a leftover 2. So the square root of 2. Now I'm going to put a big plus sign in the middle. And I'm going to go do the same thing for the 98. So I'm going to take 98 over here. I know that that is 2 times 49. That is 7 times 7. I need to write the pairs first. Notice there's a 3 already there, so that's going to already be in the front. And then I'm going to have the square root of 7 squared, and then I'm going to have the square root of this guy that was left over. So then here, these cancel, I get 2, this cancel, I get 2, and here I still have the square root of 2. Here these cancel and I get 7, and I still have the square root of 2. So when I multiply the outsides together, I get 4 square root of 2. When I multiply these outsides together, I get 21 square root of 2. And now they are like terms. They both have a radicand of 2. So they both have a 2 inside the radical. So if I have 4 square root of 2's plus 21 square root of 2's, that means I'm going to have a total of 25 square root of 2's. And this is the final answer. So you do have to simplify those square roots to make sure that they're actually like terms before you go ahead and add or subtract them.